Yeah, I feel like, and I feel like as a coach, like, does it, 'cause once, like, you can only do so much, and then once the draft is over, once the game is on, you just kind of have to see that, sit there, and you see it all, right? Like, you see all the mistakes. And, like, once they're in game, it's like you no longer, and once it's like tournament time, you no longer can be like, hey, don't do that. Hey, what are you doing, bro? Like, oh, why are you rotating that way? Like, and that's got to be nail biting. That's got to be probably one of the most frustrating parts of being a coach, I feel like.
It is like if you ask every coach that you know, or even like players and stuff, you know, if you ask them what position is the most stressful, like people would say coaching is the most stressful because like the players have a say of you know have a say with regards to the outcome of the game, right? Because they're natural ones playing the game. But as a coach, you literally can't do anything. After the draft, you sit down, you watch a game, and you that's the time where you feel like the weakest because you don't have anything to put in to kind of control the outcome. So you're just there, and you're helpless as you know. You're the most helpless person in the world. So I think that's the most stressful part about the like the coaching stuff, right? Because the thing is, like the players, they have they have that confidence. Once they get inside the game, they don't really care about anything at all. But as a coach, after the draft, you do care about the outcome. But like you're just there, you know, you're just watching the game, and there's literally nothing you can do about it. So it's stressful as hell, you know.
Yeah, I can imagine.